can be innovative. Any customer could be innovative. Some people have put some money in a treasury bills.
Their own personal money.
Money. They have invested in treasury bills. And they want to do...
And they bring the certificate.
Yes. We can put a lien on treasury bills. So there are so many. We also do third-party collateral.
Really?
Yes. That means
third-party collateral.
Yeah, that I don't have a collateral, but my friend have a collateral.
Or my father or my spouse.
Or my father, yes. We can take that.
Really? As long as that person is willing to
sign.
He's
willing to sign, yes.
What about those who might want to hide, not hide now, let me not use the word hide, who might want to put themselves under the umbrella of an association, like a professional body.
Okay.
Or a civic body, like their church or mosque.
Okay.
And the professional association or the civic body, like the church, wants to guarantee, or maybe the town association, for instance, wants to guarantee the loan. Is that acceptable?
It's always acceptable, but the bank, the onus is on the bank to be sure what is actually the viability or the validity of such guarantee.
Umbrella body.
Yes. There is something that the bank will see and say
that
yes.
That gives you reassurance.
Reassurance that this will happen. That because of their weight, that this person is not going to misbehave, or they are able to help this person out in time.
In case of default,
yes,
that they can pay back.
Yes. For example,
so that's acceptable, provided you can see the comfort.
Yes.
And you can see that there is a capacity for them to meet up with the obligation required.
Obviously.
Should this happen?
For example, if we are financing a customer and he's a supplier to a big firm. So we are providing him facility so that he's able to process products to supply to a flour mill, for example. And the flour mill is guaranteeing us that because they are the one to pay him, they are guaranteeing us that they will pay. Because they are in control of the money, the payment, that is what we call corporate guarantee.
Yeah.
You can get a corporate guarantee. In whatever
that
guise.
Also helps.
Yes, we can.
So it's really not casting concrete.
No. If so long as you provide comfort.
Creative,
yes,
one of
you are creative.
For instance, if I want to act as a supplier to Nigerian breweries, for example, which is an established brand in this country. And they are willing to guarantee. It's not their company. I'm the one who wants to take the loan, maybe to have a wheat farm.
Yes.
And Bank of Industry can get a guarantee from Nigerian breweries that,
look,
we are going to be off-takers for this guy.
Yes.
He doesn't have a piece of land yet. He doesn't even have a cutlass yet. But we are going to be off-takers for whatever wheat comes from the farm he's setting out to establish. That will be acceptable to
that we can work with.
So one can be creative. So if you have a record of performance, for instance, if you've been working in a farm that supplies a brewery, some of the products that they use in their production, and you have a relationship with that, you can resign your employment based on your pedigree and antecedent as somebody who understands the technicalities of the business and sign a contract with a brewery that over the next 10 years you're going to supply us this specs, this specification of wheat and grain, and then you can take that MOU to the Bank of Industry to request for a loan, and from that loan you can now set up your farm, and with that farm you can grow and sell and plow back your investment. Fantastic.
Yeah, such innovation is always welcome, especially in the agricultural value chain, where we emphasize on market approach.
On market approach.